Hi everybody, welcome back to the channel. I'm Steven. This is Steven in Stereo, and in today's video we are diving into more of those 5 seconds of summer tracks that I have not heard before. So I want to give a huge shout out to Madison on Patreon for actually requesting this video. Thank you so much. Today we are checking out Lost in Reality again off of the She's Kinda Hot EP. I'm pretty fucking hyped. The last track that we checked out, I believe it was Over and Out, is definitely my favorite 5 seconds of summer song. It's like definitely in my top three now. That song was just everything that I have grown to love about this group. Before we dive into this video, I just want to plug my Patreon. I do so much 5 Second Summer content, and I recently did, well, I did Carpool Karaoke, I did How Did We End Up Here, the movie. I have done two of their albums. I'm working on the 5 Second of Summer tour diaries. God, I have so much over there. So if you guys are interested, oh, and I just did on the album Youngblood, which was an Apple Music behind the scenes kind of thing, which was super fucking cool. It's all about the writing style for Youngblood. Okay, all those things out of the way, I'm ready to dive in and enjoy this, so let's go. Is that Michael? Fuck. Be away like your cigarettes. Then pick up the pieces of whatever's left. Oh. Me, they're yours to give. A million and one ways that I've tried to turn it around, leave it all behind. But every time you turn out to be one step ahead of me. Lost in reality. Yes! Okay, I love this style, and it's fine. Okay, let me try to sum this up very quickly. You can like a band, and that means enjoying every era of them, but you can also like certain eras more. It's just the way that it is. I love this era of 5 Second of Summer because it makes me nostalgic of music that I grew up on. However, I bow down to Youngblood, Calm, and what is probably going to be 5 Second of Summer 5. To me, when you like a band, you encapsulate everything that is that band, which includes these EPs and Calm. And I see people argue about it all the time, about what is better. And I don't really think that's the right way to go about things. If you appreciate a band and you appreciate what they do as artists, you want to embrace their artistic ability to continue to grow and change. And I can tell you that my record collection is full of bands with discographies that are all over the place because they start as one sound and they grow. And I feel like writing an album when you're like a kid and then visiting an album in your late 20s, I feel like the sound is going to be different. And I think that we should just learn to embrace and appreciate music past, present, whatever, instead of constantly comparing a band to sounds that they'll never do again or that they probably won't do again versus, you know, more pop tracks. And I feel like there's nothing wrong with just embracing a band regardless of those things. Now let me enjoy this shit. Is that Haley? Who's Haley? A lot of claps. Under all the lights and the night sky, you drift away, then you disappear. Counting the days till I bring you back. God damn. You disappear. Counting the days till I bring you back to me eventually. My stronger heart needs your angel. Oh. Whatever. more. This phone-in thing, very much like American Idiot. Lost in reality. I can feel you in the dark when I fall asleep. Up into my head are pictures of memories, words that you said to me. Hey, hey, Haley, won't you save me? Lost in reality. Yeah! I love that. Oh my god, my heart rate is always going when we fucking check out some of their older tracks because I just feel like ashing on those drums, man. I mean, the pacing is high in a lot of their newer tracks as well, but not to the extent of this, very much that punk rock feel. A lot of beats per minute. Woo, my heart is going. I fucking love hearing them in this style, and I think it makes me appreciate Youngblood and Calm even more. Just to see the growth. And I talk about that every time. But it's because I really want to just layer in the fact that bands change sounds and bands evolve. And I feel like when you hear what they were doing here, and you hear what they're doing with Youngblood and Calm, that growth is incredible. Because as much as I love this sound, this is a sound that a lot of bands sounded like. And to me, that's fine. I mean, I listen to metal bands where you sometimes can't even tell the difference between one or the other. But I feel like in this genre, I know that 5 Seconds of Summer came in a little late to the game for this style. So it's really fucking cool that they were able to pick up and do what they did. But a lot of these bands sound the same. Even to this day, I go back and listen to pop punk records and I'm like, god damn, these all sound the same. And what I love is that they were able to take their love for music as well as some of the influence they use in this sound, they were able to transition that and grow with that. And they put out an album like fucking Youngblood, which does not sound like any other album. It does not sound like any other band. And I feel the same with Calm. That thing comes out and you're like, god damn, the musical influences on these albums are so different from what I heard in the past. And that makes me happy because we continue to see them rising in popularity and rising in fame. And I don't know. In my personal opinion, if you really love a band, you want to see them grow, morph, and change to continue to have that success while also being happy making the music that they want to make. And I imagine that I would love to make this album today, but if I had the musical talent to make Calm, I would probably prefer making Calm because I would feel really great about it when I put it out. And yeah, so I fucking love this. Madison, thank you so much for supporting me on Patreon and showing me more of this. You guys know I love this group. Like, it's been, I think, like about a year since the first time I checked them out. And since then, I have dove into so many moments of this group. And I think it's just because I get a lot of nostalgia from watching and listening to like older stuff. And I just like really appreciate that they had the bravery to come out with the albums that they did that I think really put their mark on music history as where they were as a band. And I cannot wait for 5 Sauce 5 because I'm really interested to see what they've been cooking up behind the scenes that we don't know about. So huge shout out to everyone that supports me on here. Let me know in the comment section something cool about 5 Seconds of Summer. Let me know something that I don't know about 5 Seconds of Summer. And yeah, make sure to check out Patreon if you want to support me and get access to all the behind the scenes cool stuff that I do about this band. And I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.